Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Let's continue your exercise 1.2, question number 4. Question number 4 is, if AB is 5 cm, BP is 2 cm and AP is 3.4 cm, compare the segments. Compare means you have to decide the greater and smaller segment. If you observe the values, AB value is 5 and BP value is 2 and AP value is 3.4. So, 5 is greater than 3.4 and 3.4 is greater than 2. If you compare the values, then you can find AB is greater than AP and AP is greater than BP. So, this is your answer. Next, question number 5. Write the answers to the following question with reference to the figure. One line is given to you and you have to observe this line and answer the questions given below. Okay, the first question, write the name of opposite ray of RP. Now see in figure, ray RP going to the right hand side. From same point R, the one ray is going to the right hand side, left hand side, that is ray RS or ray RT. From point R, there are two rays. One is going to the right hand side direction and one is going to the left hand side direction. So these are called as opposite ray. Opposite rays does mean one is that means opposite direction or from same point going to the opposite directions. Okay. Next question. Write the intersection set of ray PQ and ray RP. Intersection means the common. The common ray between the two rays or a common segment or a common line or a common point between the two rays is called the intersection set. Now observing figure, ray PQ. Ray PQ is going to the right hand side direction. Same ray RP is also going to the right hand side direction. When RP is more forward, then it meet with PQ. So your answer, that is the intersection or the common part, is PQ or ray PQ. So your answer is ray PQ. Okay. Next question, third. Write the union set of ray PQ and ray QR. Union means combined, joined. So join the PQ and ray PQ and ray QR, ray PQ and ray QR. If you join both, then you get line QR. So your answer is line QR. Next question number 4. State the ray of which segment QR is the subset. Subset means the part. So see in the figure, segment QR lies under R, ray RQ, ray SQ, ray TQ. So next question number 5. Write the pair of opposite ray with common end point R. Now from point R there are two rays. One is going to the left and one is going to the right. So your answer is ray RP and ray RS. You can write ray RP and ray RT. Next, write any two rays with common end point S. From point S, there are two rays. One is left side and one is right hand side. That means opposite ray. So your answer is ray SR, ray ST. Next, number 7. Write the intersection set of ray SP and ST. Observe in figure, SP and ST, both rays are intersect at point S. So your answer is point S. Okay, so intersection point of this rays is point S. Last question of the exercise, question number 6. Answer the following question with the help of a figure. Observe here, one line is given to you and these points and their coordinates are given, and you have to give the answers of the question given below. First question, state the point which are equidistant from point B. See in the figure, from point B, same distance, equidistant point from B, equidistant point A, and from that side C. Point P and point D are also equidistant from point B. So your answer is point A and point C, point P and point D are equidistant from point B. Second question, write a pair of point equidistant from point Q, same as question number 1, equidistant point from point Q. Observe the line from point Q, the equidistant point L, from that side point Q. point P and point R. These points are equidistant from point Q. Okay. Next, question number 3. Find the distance between point UB, distance between point PC, distance between point VB and distance between point U and L. We practice this type of question in exercise 1.1. How to find the distance between the two points. The greater coordinate minus smaller coordinate is the distance between the two points. Okay. First one, distance between point U and V. Point U in between minus 4 and minus 6. So the coordinate of point U is minus 5. And point V in between 4 and 6. So coordinate of point V is 5. So here 5 is greater than minus 5. So distance between the point U and V. Greater coordinate minus smaller coordinate. So 5 minus minus 5 minus minus plus. So 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. So distance between point U and V is 10 unit. Next, distance between point P and C. Observe in the line, coordinate of point P is minus 2 and coordinate of point C is 4. Now here 4 is greater than minus 2. So therefore the distance between point P and C is greater coordinate minus smaller coordinate. That means 4 minus minus 2 minus minus plus. So 4 plus 2, your answer is 6. So distance between point P and C is 6 unit. Okay. Next, distance between point V and B. Coordinate of V 5. Coordinate of B is 2. Here 5 is greater than 2. So therefore distance between point V and B, 5 minus 2 is equal to 3 unit. Next, distance between point U and L. Coordinate of point U minus 5. Coordinate of point L minus 3. Here minus 3 is greater than minus 5. So therefore distance between point U and L, greater coordinate minus smaller coordinate. Here greater coordinate is minus 3. So minus 3 minus minus 5 is smaller coordinate. So minus 3 minus minus, it's plus 5. So plus 5 minus 3, your answer is 2. So therefore the distance between point U and L is 2 unit. Here we have completed practice set 1.2. Practice set, if any doubt, ask me. Let's start practice set 1.3. is easy practice set. Question number 1. Write the following statement in if then form. If then form sentences are called conditional sentences, or they are also called an implication statement. Okay. In English grammar, you have studied how to apply, how to write if then form of sentence. If is we write if with first sentence and then with second sentence. So if then form of sentences are called as implication sentence, or they are also called as conditional statements. Okay. The first question is, the opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. Okay. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. Parallelogram is a quadrilateral. So your answer is, if a quadrilateral is parallelogram, then the opposite angle of that quadrilateral are congruent. Got it? If with first sentence and then with second sentence. So if a quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then the opposite angle of that quadrilateral are congruent. Now second, the diagonal of rectangle are congruent. Again, rectangle is also a quadrilateral. So if a quadrilateral is a rectangle, then the diagonal of that quadrilateral are congruent, same as first. Okay. Again, I am repeating, rectangle is also a quadrilateral. So your conditional statement is, if a quadrilateral is rectangle, then the diagonal of that quadrilateral are congruent. Okay. Next, third one, in an isosceles triangle, the segment joining the vertex and the midpoint of a base is perpendicular to the base. Here two sentences are there. The first is, in an isosceles triangle, then the segment joining the vertex and the midpoint of the base is perpendicular to the base. So that your answer is, if a triangle is isosceles, then the segment joining the vertex and the midpoint of a base is perpendicular to the base. It's easy. if with first sentence, then with second sentence. Okay, use if with the first sentences and then with the second sentence. Next, question number 2. Write converse of the following statement. Here we have to write the converse statement. This type of questions also you study in English grammar. Write the converse of the statement. So here one statement is given to you and you have to write its converse statement. Okay, so first question is, the alternate angle formed by two parallel lines and their transversal are congruent. Again, I am repeating, the alternate angles formed by two parallel lines and their transversal are congruent. The converse statement is, if the alternate angle made by the transversal with two parallel lines are congruent, then the lines are parallel. So this is your answer, that is a converse statement. If the alternate angles made by the transversal with two lines are congruent, then the lines are parallel. Converse means opposite, or you can say that invert. You have to invert the sentences. So it's called converse statement. Next, if a pair of interior angles made by a transversal of two lines are supplementary, then the lines are parallel. Here two sentences are there, you have to invert that sentence. So that type of sentence called as inverse statement. So your answer is, if two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, then pair of interior angles are supplementary. Again, I am repeating the converse statement. If the two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, then the pair of interior angles are supplementary. Okay. Now the next is, the diagonals of a rectangle are congruent. So the answer is, if the diagonals of a quadrilateral are congruent, then the quadrilateral is a rectangle. So this is the converse statement. Converse means opposite, or you can say that inverse. Okay. Inverse of the sentence is called converse statement. So your answer is, if the diagonals of quadrilateral are congruent, then the quadrilateral is a rectangle. Here we have completed exercise 1.3. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakallah.